They're kicking off in Serbia.
The way Djokovic has been treated just shows a huge misalignment in the levels of power in Australia.
And Novak's father, he seems pretty angry as well.
Novak, Australia, Scott, Morrison, Balkanas.
Father!
Novak. They are trampling over Novak, and with this, they are trampling over Serbia. And by doing that, they are trampling on the Serbian people.
As for his...
Father!
As a mother, how can I feel? I feel terrible that they are keeping him as a prisoner. It's just not fair. It's not human.
And the anger goes right to the top.
Do you agree that it is political persecution?
I can't really see anything else.
But Barnaby's not having a bar of it.
Sometimes I get a sense that people who make a lot of money start believing they've evolved somehow above the laws of the land, whether you like them or not. We saw this with Mr. Depp, and I'm not saying that Mr. Djokovic is Mr. Depp.
Did no one come to save me just because they missed me?
The reality is a visa can be cancelled at the airport, but the correct procedure has to be followed, which is obviously why it's been appealed.
It's still not enough to soothe the Joker's Serbian supporters.
Novak! Novak!
His accommodation?
Yes.
Terrible.
Imagine they will keep the best athlete in the world in prison until Monday.
But if they think that's harsh, wait till I meet some of Novak's new neighbours.
Hello everyone, my name is Joy. I'm in Melbourne Park Prison of Torture Centre. Almost 2 years for no reason.
Advocates taking advantage of the media circus to highlight the plight of those seeking asylum.
The world's most celebrated athlete is hauled up under the same roof as these most desperate, vulnerable people who did nothing but seek refuge in this country that is meant to be fair and just.
We came for safety, not for play tennis. It is not fair. Please, we want freedom.
We're joined now by Mehdi, an Iranian refugee detained in the same hotel as Djokovic. Mehdi, what do you make of all the media attention?
Well, yesterday a few people messaged me over Facebook and Twitter, and they said that they did not know about what's going on in Park Hotel. And they came here for Djokovic, and they found out about our circumstances, and they were shocked. And to be honest, I'm kind of like, I got excited. And at the same time, I got disappointed and I got sad because it's been 9 years and that's why they found out about us.
So how long have you been there in the Park Hotel?
A couple of months I've been in Park Hotel.
And what's an average day look like for you?
As well, me personally, I try to sleep as much as I can to waste my day, to kill the time, though I have sleeping problems. And most of the time I'm laying on the bed or read books or watch movies.
So what's the government told you about where your situation is up to? Do you have any hope that you're going to be able to get out?
Well, there's always hope, but it's up to the minister. We ask ABF, we ask the caseworker. They tell us it's up to the minister. And no one actually give us a deadline. I've been in detention for more than almost 9 years, though I never committed a crime in my whole life. I've served my time, you know?
Mehdi, you're being held in detention in a hotel in the middle of a metropolitan city in Australia. Right outside your window, you can see ordinary life just happen. You're so close to the life you want to be a part of. In many ways, is this more difficult than being held in detention offshore?
Well, there's a window, basically, among me and freedom. And the air behind the window is freedom, and the air inside my room is jail. Basically, to describe it as short as possible. Nauru was... I diagnosed by PTSD because of Nauru. I got traumatized. It was such a cruel place, and it wasn't safe. It wasn't safe at all. Me, personally, I was about to die there at times, you know.
The UN says that you're a genuine refugee. Today is your 24th birthday. You've been in detention since you were a 15-year-old child. It's disgusting.
Yeah.
How hopeful are you that this global spotlight could change your situation?
I feel like this is a wave. When Djokovic is going to get out of here, probably no one's going to pay attention to us. I really hope the media is going to continue to cover our story, continue speaking about us, especially the media that's inside Australia. I really hope that the media put pressure to the government, and I hope Djokovic himself is going to speak about us, as he has a strong voice.
Are you aware at all, Mehdi, whether or not Djokovic knows about the stories of the people who were there at the Park Hotel?
Well, I'm not sure. I haven't seen him. I couldn't speak to him. Though he's a level, like, just underneath me. It's unbelievable that Djokovic is, he's been detained at the same place that I am detained, and he's going to eat the same food that I'm eating.
At the moment, Djokovic is using his platform to talk about and make criticisms of our government's handling of COVID restrictions. If you could speak to Novak and ask him to use his platform in a different way, what would you say to him?
You are experiencing detention for a short period of time, and you know how it is to watch people having life over the window and you don't have one. I'm just telling him that, speak about us. Tell the world how cruel it is to keep human beings in rooms, in detentions, indefinitely.
Mehdi, thank you so much for your time, and it's incumbent on all of us in journalism to not let this focus fade away. Thank you.
Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to speak today.
What incredible strength shown there by Mehdi to join us on the program, talk about his experiences, but wouldn't it be some kind of irony if, you know, 24 hours ago, the most hated man in Australia, Novak Djokovic, becomes the hero that could potentially do something about that situation that those legitimate refugees find themselves in?
And it's almost like we get a microcosm of the very two different sides of Australian life there. In the same hotel, you have a man who the Australian government, our state governments, will do anything to get him out of there because we put on a world-class sporting event. But in the same hotel, we've got these refugees that we treat so horribly. Mm-hmm. Our system for immigration is, like, from a different world.
I'm almost ashamed. I mean, I've written so many times about border protection in this country against it. You know, I've long been a bleeding heart. I gave up. Like, I gave up years ago because it just felt like the Australian community wasn't for turning. The Liberal Party always managed to divide Labor on the stopping the boats, even get them on board with the principle. But this is somebody being used as reverse bait, reverse human bait. It's just disgusting. And it does need to have a light shone on it pretty much permanently, frankly.